What's going on, guys? In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can set up your Cypherium wallet. There is not a lot of information online, or at least I wasn't able to find that much information. I believe they used to have some instruction on their website, but either it's gone or I just couldn't find it. But either way, I'm going to show you how you can set up their wallet on Android and iOS, because it's going to be a little bit different. And if you're an Android user but you have any iOS device such as iPad or iPhone, I would recommend using that, because it's actually available in the App Store, meaning that the app gets code checked by Apple, so it's less likely to have any issues with it. But if you have an Android, it still should be fine. I would recommend using a spare device if you have it, with not a lot of personal information, and I would rather see them add this to Google Play, where it actually gets code checked as well by Google. But it is what it is, and if you trust the project, then it should be okay. And so let me show you how to do it on both, and we're gonna start with the iOS device because it's a little bit easier, and then we're gonna proceed with Android. So we're in my iPad, and you can either use iPad or you can use iPhone as well. And the first thing that you're gonna do, you're gonna click on App Store and you're gonna search for Cypherium Wallet. And it's gonna look just like that, Cypherium Wallet. And you're gonna click on download, and once it installs, you're gonna click open. You can allow or don't allow notifications, it doesn't matter. And here's the home page. So the first thing that we're gonna do, we're gonna give it a name, and then we're gonna choose a password. So I'm just gonna call it Cypherium. And for the password, you can use numbers and letters, and it doesn't take special characters. All right, once you enter the password, you're gonna click next. And here's our 12-word seed phrase, also called mnemonic seed phrase. So what I recommend doing is taking a sheet of paper, maybe like this or a thicker one, and write it down, or better yet, take two or three so you can put it in multiple places and hide them. And don't use any of the online storage options such as Google Cloud or OneDrive or Dropbox, anything like that, because it's best to keep it safe offline. So let me write it down. All right, now that I wrote it down, on the next screen, once we click next, we're gonna have to put it in the same order just to confirm that we got it right. So we're gonna do left to right, top to bottom. And once you entered it, you're gonna click verify. And that's it. Your Cypherium wallet is now created, and you can see your balance right here. You can also do send and receive. So if you have it on Maxi Exchange or XT Exchange, where you can currently, there are the only two exchanges where you can buy it, you can later on send it to this non-custodial wallet and keep it safe off the centralized exchanges. And to do that, you're just gonna click receive. And here you can either scan the QR code or you can copy this address, and you can use that to send your Cypherium to this non-custodial wallet. And that was it for iOS, it was that simple. And now, let me show you how you can do it on Android, where you download the file, what you need to enable in your security settings to be able to install it. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, so in order to install Cypherium Wallet on Android, what you're gonna need to do, you're gonna need to open any browser, like Google Chrome in my case, and you're gonna need to go to a GitHub URL that has the APK installation file. And by the way, I'm gonna drop the link down in the description below so that you can use it, because it's kind of hard to find. So once we're here, we're gonna see we have this APK and we have 9.7 megabyte file right here. So you're gonna click on three dots, and you're gonna click on download. This will download our installation file. Some of the phone manufacturers might give you this warning saying that this file might be harmful, so you're gonna click download anyway. And once it's downloaded, you're gonna click open. And it says that for your security, your phone currently isn't allowed to install unknown apps from this source, meaning that the only allowed place to install the apps is Google Play. And again, it's better to install it from Google Play because they do some code check, but this is just a known source, so you're basically trusting them that it's not harmful. So if you want to allow installation, you can click settings. And you need to go to the menu, settings menu, that says install unknown apps. And you're going to have to toggle this toggle on. In my case, it's Chrome. It can be Samsung browser or maybe Edge, whatever browser you use on your Android phone. You're going to toggle it on for that browser. And then you're going to click install and app installed. Now you're going to click open. And it looks exactly the same as on iOS. So we have wallet name, and then we have choose a new password and repeat your password. So I'm gonna give the wallet name and I'm gonna enter the password. Once you've done that, you're gonna click next. And again, we have our 12-word seed phrase that I recommend writing down on a piece of paper and storing it somewhere securely. Once you wrote it down, you're gonna click next, and then you're gonna reproduce the same order that you wrote it down. So we're gonna do left to right and top to bottom. Once you've done that, you're gonna click verify, and that is it. Your Cypherium wallet is now set up. You can see the balance again. You can do send and receive. So you can click receive, scan the code or copy this wallet address, and you're good to go. And please remember not to use the seed phrase that I just created for this Android wallet or from the iOS wallet previously, because this seed phrase is now exposed and anybody can use that to steal your funds. I'm not gonna use it. I'm gonna throw it out after I'm done with this tutorial. All right, guys, and that was it. Now you're able to install your Cypherium wallet for both Android and iOS. I would say that for the peace of mind, just use iOS, even though I don't think there's gonna be any issues with Android. But still, with Apple, the code gets actually checked, so it's a little better, in my opinion, to use iOS rather than Android. But you can still use extra Android if you are worried about your personal information being stolen or anything like that. I hope that was useful, and if you found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up to help YouTube algorithm. And if you want to see more stuff like this, where I talk about crypto news, do crypto tutorials, and do personal finance and general finance news as well, please subscribe to my channel down below, and I'll see you all guys in the next one.